every worry about sickness in your future, every worry about your future is a made-up reality in your imagination. So I'm like, let's use those imaginations for the good. So I actually use my imagination. Now, sometimes you get promises from God, right? Like God could come to me and say, Abby, you will be healed. And I could be like, yes, Lord, I'm going to be healed. And then I could imagine it. That is one way that God speaks, is he speaks to you. You have a promise. It helps you see that in the future something good is going to happen. That is very valuable. There's another kind of promise, which is who God is. So like, God hasn't told me specifically that he's going to heal me, but he's a healer. So I imagine my future with healing. Not because he told me, but because why wouldn't I? I like could choose to hate my life and imagine it horrible, or I could choose to imagine that good things are going to happen. And I literally had to use this muscle because most of us don't imagine good things coming down the road. So one of the ways that I did this is I started writing myself letters from the future. So like, dear Abby, 2020, I'm so happy and thankful now that I feel so free in my own skin. I have hope all the time. I'm no longer scared of sickness. I'm no longer afraid of what I can't do. I feel every day so powerful, and like every step I take takes ground for the Lord. Dear Abby, like, and I do this in every area. So like with money, I wrote myself like 30 letters from the future. Because I needed to deal with some poverty mentality that I had. And so I went to, and it would be like, dear Abby, now I actually probably wrote it. I need to go back and look because I probably did like 2018. So I'm getting close. Dear Abby, 2018, I'm so happy and thankful now that every time I spend money, I don't have a pit in my stomach. That I actually believe with all that I am, that no matter what's happening in my finances, God is a good provider, that I'm not scared about money, that when I think about money, I have a good friendship with it. I don't feel like it's always running away from me. Now me and money are friends. Like, I literally write out what I want to feel, and then I write it from the future past so I can imagine actually that happens. Now, for me personally, you can write specific circumstances like, dear Abby, you're now married and have won the lotto. I'm so happy and thankful now that I've won the lotto and you never have to worry. But here's what I'll tell you. Fake hope doesn't produce fruit. And so I write about the future and what I feel and the freedom that God has done inside of me. Because no matter what circumstances happen, that can't be stolen. So I may not be a millionaire in 2 years, but I may have broken through the poverty spirit. And that feels really valuable to me. So I want you guys to just close your eyes for a second. And I want you to pick one area of your life. And I want you to imagine that in 5 years, you are going to see breakthrough in that area. That in 5 years, you are going to see the goodness of God in a way that surpasses what you think. Now again, not lotto, but like in 5 years, you feel free. In 5 years, you're not struggling with self-hatred like you were. In 5 years, you can talk to anybody because you have courage. In 5 years, that deep struggle with doubt is not plaguing you anymore. In 5 years, you like who you are. In 5 years, you actually have seen fruit come in your life. In 5 years, you believe that when you pray, God listens. In 5 years, you've seen that he is faithful. In 5 years, you are more convinced that he is on your team than you've ever been before. Amen.